This is my true life American Horror Story Hotel. Who's texting me? Bianca? Ooh, my lip gloss looks good. That pimple, though. Ooh. I have an itch in my ear. Hold on. Is my flashlight going in and out? Like, come on. Get with the program here. Sandstorm. This is my true life American Horror Story Hotel. Happy Halloween, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Alatorre. Join the family, hit that subscribe button. Okay, 2020 has already been spooky enough, and a lot of you may not be in the mood to celebrate Halloween. I haven't been in the mood. I didn't dress up this year, didn't do any makeup tutorials, and a lot of you are staying at home, staying safe, staying healthy, and so I thought it was about time I finally have the courage, the strength. Today is gonna be a story time video about my real life American Horror Story Hotel story when I accidentally stayed the night at Hotel Cecil here in Los Angeles. Some of you may already know about this hotel. If you watch Mykie of Glam and Gore, she actually recently did a video covering this hotel. It's a 40-minute long video. I watched it before to see if I missed any information that I might want to share in this video. And if you know Mykie of Glam and Gore, you know that she's all about ghosts and all things spooky, glam and gore, as it says in her name. And in that video, she said, "I will not stay at this hotel. It is just too scary." And I'm like, bitch, I stayed there. I sure did. And it was all a complete accident. And that is what I'm gonna be sharing today. And let me just tell all of you, like, first of all, I absolutely love when I get together with friends and the conversation suddenly takes a really dark turn and we're all sharing really spooky, scary, or like paranormal type stories with one another. It's my absolute favorite, even though, you know, later that night you can't sleep, all your hands and feet are tucked underneath the sheets and maybe it's over your head as well and you're so freaked out. So I hope that you are not sleeping alone tonight. But I will let you know, aside from the actual hotel, Hotel Cecil being absolutely terrifying, my story is more so suspenseful, and it's just a really bizarre, very, very bizarre series of events that led to this one monumental moment that I was like, what? How? And what's really weird is that Lady Gaga is at the center of this entire story, hence why I'm wearing my Joanne tee, my Joanne merch from Coachella. R.I.P. Coachella 2020. My sister and I are huge Lady Gaga fans, and it's really what has like bonded us. We've always gone to her concerts together, and this story is one of them. So grab a drink, grab a snack. If you are, you know, wherever it is that you're watching this, if you are of age and able to drink, highly recommend it. And let's get into the story of how my sister and I accidentally stayed at Hotel Cecil. First of all, I don't know why I'm sitting like that. I feel like I'm just like trying to like hold myself and comfort myself because I looked at Kyle today and I said, are you thankful I'm still alive after this? Because I sure am. Wrote down some notes. I actually sent this to my friend slash assistant with a voice memo, and she saw the notes before listening to the voice memo, and she was like, my god, what did you just send me? This is terrifying. So the story goes south real quick. I'm gonna start off by taking you back to 2017-2018. Remember, this story has been a long series of events dating back to 2011 all the way up until 2017, 2018. So 2017, 2018, my friend Lauren, who is also a really big Lady Gaga fan, calls me and says that they are selling tickets to recordings or tapings of A Star Is Born for all of Lady Gaga's scenes where she's performing. So essentially what they were doing was selling tickets for $15. All the money was being donated to Lady Gaga's Born This Way Foundation. Not to be confused with the foundation. Every time I post about it, people are like, the foundation by Too Faced? No. The Born This Way Foundation by Lady Gaga is a nonprofit that helps bring awareness to mental health, especially amongst younger people. And so all the money being raised from her performances in A Star Is Born were being donated to a good cause. So of course I was like, hell yeah, I wanna go, let's do it. So we got to go to, or be extras. Essentially that's what you were doing. You're paying $15 to be an extra in the movie. We went to a taping of the final scene in A Star Is Born when she is singing I'll Never Love Again. It was the best experience. I have never seen Gaga perform in that sort of setting. It was super intimate. It was about like 100 of us and they made it look like it was a full venue. It was at the Shrine here in Los Angeles. It was an all-day shoot and so worth it. Like, there was not a dry eye in the house. All of us were crying. The tears were real. It was just an amazing opportunity. So coming home from that, my friend Lauren and I were on such a high note. We were on cloud nine. And we were kind of like, well, what do we do now? Like, we just went to this like epic taping of A Star Is Born, witnessed something so incredible. What do we do now? So 2017, 2018 was also during the premiere of American Horror Story Hotel, starring Lady Gaga. So we just come home from seeing Lady Gaga perform and we're like, well, let's watch American Horror Story Hotel and support our girl Gaga, you know, just like keep it going. And honestly, I'm not a huge fan of American Horror Story. I know, don't come at me, okay? I know there's huge fans out there. Some of you watching are probably like, what? I'm offended. I don't know, I've never gone into it, but because the season had Gaga on it, I was like, sure, let's watch it. No one else had wanted to see it with me, even though it was literally the one night that Kyle was out of town. Why did I think it was a good idea to watch American Horror Story, knowing I was gonna be sleeping alone that night because Lauren was gonna be leaving me? I don't know. Nothing in this story makes sense. So we're watching American Horror Story Hotel, and Lauren, being born and raised in LA, a true Angeleno, goes, well, you know that this is based off of a real hotel in LA that's like super, has like this really, really bad history. I'm like, oh, no way, that's like so crazy. Tell me more, like I'm intrigued, I wanna know more about this hotel. She's like, yeah, it's called the Hotel Cecil. But they've changed the name since then. Anyway, we continue watching the show, and then out of nowhere, I get another brilliant idea to Google the hotel. I'm like, I wanna look up the hotel. I wanna see what kind of reviews it has. It has to have some pretty interesting reviews on Yelp, right? So I pull up my phone and I Google Hotel Cecil. It pops up on Yelp. It has like, I don't know, like 2.5 stars. It has photos. It has really, really bad reviews. Let's actually read some of the reviews, right? Let's see. $1 sign, so you know it's affordable. 1-star review from Kristen L. As others have said, the beautiful lobby is just a fantastic illusion. Once I stepped out the elevator, I knew I was in trouble. I was alone with my 2-year-old. We step into a hallway that made me think we were stepping back in time. Paint peeling, tiles all jacked up, shared bathroom that was nasty, and the room. I walked into a bed and a sink. The bedding had holes and stains. There was no AC in the midst of July. I cracked the window to get some kind of air and heard the lovely sounds of a woman screaming down the street. Needless to say, there was not much sleep for my daughter and I. It takes a lot to freak me out, but this place did me in, and I did not know the history of this hotel nor ever heard of it before I stayed there. Okay, so I have looked up the hotel, I'm on Yelp, and I decide to click on the photos because there's photos from guests that have stayed at the hotel. I'm like, ooh, this is so creepy. Ooh, look at that creepy bed. Look at that old decor. Ooh, those rooms look so dark and damp and dingy. But then, as I continue scrolling, there's some more up-to-date photos. modern, bright orange, almost like IKEA type decor. And it suddenly clicks. This is a reenactment of me scrolling on my phone and realizing what I have just seen. I stayed here. Lauren, I've stayed at this hotel. What did you say they changed the name to? And she goes, oh, I think it's called Stay on Main. It was at that very moment that I realized my sister and I, back in 2011, stayed at Hotel Cecil, but were under the impression we were staying at a hotel called Stay on Main, all because we had driven up from San Diego to LA to go to a Lady Gaga concert. I know, right? We were going to the Monster Ball in 2011 at Staples Center, and because we were still living in San Diego and we were broke college students, we decided that we were gonna find a cheap hotel to stay at that night just to crash, so that after the concert, if we had a few drinks or just, like, you know, we didn't wanna worry about having to drive home super late. San Diego to LA is about a 2.5-3 hour drive depending on traffic, and yes, there is still traffic in LA at midnight. It's shocking. If you have not experienced it, I'm here to tell you, it sometimes takes, that 2.5 hour drive sometimes takes 3 to 4 hours. So we knew that we didn't want to worry about having to drive home that night. So it was up to me to find us a cheap hotel. I did a general Google search, found this hotel called Stay on Main. It looked really modern, up to date. It looked nice and clean and inviting. And on top of that, it was $30 a night. So I booked it. I was like, this is cheap. It looks nice for what I was seeing online, okay? After the concert, it was super, super late. It was, you know, as all concerts end really late, it was probably like midnight. And this was pre-Uber, pre-Lyft, pre-ride-sharing era. So we had to grab a taxi from Staples Center to the hotel. And it was a mess leaving the concert. You know, everyone's like flooding the exits and everyone's trying to grab a taxi, and we kept, you know, walking a little bit further, assuming we were gonna get a taxi the further away we walked from the stadium. We eventually just ended up walking all the way to our hotel, and I wasn't really familiar with LA at the time, so that was, I want to say, my first time in Los Angeles at night, just kind of like roaming around. I didn't know that essentially, like, the area we were walking through was Skid Row. And if you're not familiar with Skid Row is where there are a lot of homeless, unfortunately, in Los Angeles. And at the time, I didn't know it was Skid Row. I knew it felt a little like, didn't feel like the safest area, but at the same time, we were just kind of like, you know, again, on cloud nine from just leaving this concert, and we were just trying to make our way home. So we finally get our way home. We were just trying to make our way back to the hotel. So let me rewind a bit and just share like my overall experience at Hotel Cecil from when we initially got there, because we did get there when it was still daylight. We got there probably around like 4 or 5 p.m. So we could get ready for the concert. The hotel is hostel style. I don't know if all the rooms are like that, but when I booked it, I knew it was a hostel style hotel, meaning that the room is just a room, and to take a shower, use the bathroom, it's a shared communal bathroom. So upon arrival, I remember checking in. When I look at the photos, and my sister sent me a photo, I'll show you guys the photos in just a bit. When we got there, it looked just like the photos, like really modern. I remember my sister making a joke and saying she thought I had booked us a doggy hotel, because there was a lot of like plastic dog figurines. you'll see one in the photo. But I do remember the old school lobby. So again, they dressed up portions of the hotel, not the entire hotel. So to my recollection, there was still an area of the hotel that had like the old school lobby. So you check in the front, but there was the old system of getting your hotel room key where all the keys are, you know, on the back wall, and then someone has to get them off the wall and hand it to you. I remember the ride up the elevator. I remember going to the room and we just kind of laughed. We laughed at the furniture. I'll pop up a photo here that my sister just sent me. And we'll get her on the phone. Hopefully she answers. There was like this orange plastic hand chair. The comforter was again, how I had seen it in the Yelp photos in 2017-18, orange. But to get ready, like if you wanted to shower, you were gonna have to use the communal bathroom. I don't recall taking a shower there. I'm pretty sure I decided I'm only gonna go to that communal bathroom to use the bathroom and that's it. I'm not gonna take a shower there. And I think my sister, same thing. I don't think she showered there either, but just that like feeling, I remember being like freaked out by the bathroom and not really liking it. And one thing I remember really, really well is that there was not a single soul seen the entire time we were there. Aside from the person that checked us in, there was no one in the elevator with us. There was no one in the hallways. There was like, I don't remember running into a single person when we were there. We got ready in the hotel room, went to the concert. You guys already know the story about us getting back. I remember my sister and I were bickering the whole way home because we were upset about not getting a taxi and having to walk all the way back to the home. Can I just call the Hotel Cecil my home? I remember arguing all the way back to the hotel. So when we got back to the hotel at night, we just went straight to bed. I think we, you know, maybe took like a restroom break, went to the restroom, but it was just not a good feeling. And then my sister had work the next morning, so we left pretty early. Altogether, we were probably at the hotel for only about like 5-6 hours, to be honest. So it was really a really quick in and out, did the job, gave us somewhere to sleep. We're still here today. That's the good news. Going back to 2017-2018, when I found out all these years later that I stayed at this famous hotel with this bad history, I then decided to look up like what had happened at this hotel, and looking at the list, it's not good. Okay, let me pull this up as well. Unnatural, violent deaths, a lot of them involving poison. The hotel opened in the 1930s, 1940s. I think at its height, or like when it opened, it was around the Great Depression. So the hotel, you know, was around, or its beginnings were during one of the worst times that you could possibly, you know, run a hotel or have a hotel. So that alone right there is not, you know, no bueno. So there's this long list of violent deaths, and all of them are dating back to, you know, years, years ago. I also want to let you know that a lot of this involves self-inflicted deaths. If that is a trigger for all of you, just warning you right now, it's okay if you log off, mute, come back later, check out now. I totally and completely understand. I know Mykie also left some resources in her description box for suicide prevention, so I will do that as well. It's just a really, this is dark. It gets dark really, really fast. So just giving you guys that warning now in case this kind of stuff just really, you know, it's stuff that you don't want to hear about. Giving you that warning now. Timeline of murders and murderers. As the area where the Cecil Hotel is located began to decline, suicides and other violent deaths on the premises became more frequent. The first documented suicide at the Cecil was reported in 1931 when a guest named W.K. Norton died in his room after taking poison capsules. 1932, Benjamin Dodich, 25, dead from a self-inflicted gunshot. 1934, former Army Medical Corps Sergeant Louis D. Borden, 53, was found dead in his room at the Cecil. Grace E. Maygrove fell from the 9th-story window. Her fall was broken by telephone wires, which were wrapped around her body. 1938, Roy Thompson, 35, jumped from Cecil's top floor and was found on the skylight of a neighboring building. 1939, Irwin C. Neblett, 39, was found dead in his room after ingesting poison. 1940, someone else ingested poison. Not funny, I don't know why I'm laughing. Dorothy Jean Purcell, 19, was sharing a room at the Cecil with her boyfriend, shoe salesman Ben Levine, 38. Purcell, who, this one's really dark. Purcell, who had apparently been unaware that she was pregnant, went into labor. She later testified that she did not want to disrupt the sleeping of Levine, so she went to the bathroom where she gave birth to a baby boy. Thinking the baby was dead, she threw him out of the window. 1964, Pigeon Goldie Osgood, a retired telephone operator, dead in her room. She had been raped, stabbed, and beaten, and her room was ransacked. Osgood was well known around the area and had earned her nickname because she fed birds in nearby Pershing Square. Pershing Square is still very much around in downtown LA. Near her body was the Los Angeles Dodgers cap she always wore and a paper sack full of birdseed. Hours after her murder, Jacques B. Ellinger, 29, was seen walking through Pershing Square in blood-stained clothing. He was arrested and charged with Osgood's murder, but was later cleared of the crime. The murder remains unsolved. Clearly he did it! In the 1980s, the hotel was rumored to be the residence of serial killer Richard Ramirez, nicknamed the Night Stalker. Ramirez had been a regular presence on the Skid Row area of Los Angeles, and according to a hotel clerk, he claims to have spoken to him, is rumored to have stayed at the Cecil for a few weeks. Ramirez may have engaged in part of his killing spree while staying there. Another serial killer, Austrian Jack Unterweger, don't know how to say his last name, stayed at the Cecil in 1991, possibly because he sought to copy Ramirez's crimes. While there, he strangled and killed at least 3 sex workers for which he was convicted in Austria. He hanged himself shortly after his conviction. So don't have to worry about that guy. Also, not sure why it's not showing up here, but it's because the death didn't actually occur at the Cecil, but it is most famously known for its association to the Black Dahlia. If you do not know about the Black Dahlia, let me give you some footnotes. It is one of the most famous unsolved murders in American history that took place in Los Angeles. And the reason it is associated with the Hotel Cecil is because the victim, Elizabeth Short, was allegedly seen at Hotel Cecil's bar, where that was the last time she was seen before she was murdered. And she was murdered in a very gruesome, like, horrific, like, kind of shit you hear about in unsolved mysteries. As I'm reading all this, I'm under the assumption that all of this is a thing of the past. All of this bad shit happened a long, long time ago. Then I read in 2013, the Cecil, by then rebranded as, you guessed it, Stay on Main, although still maintaining the original Hotel Cecil signs and painted advertisements on its exteriors, completely, did not see that when I stayed there, became the focus of a renewed attention when surveillance footage of a young Canadian student, Elisa Lam, behaving erratically in the hotel's elevator went viral. 2013, that's just 2 years after my sister and I stayed at the hotel in 2011. This is when I called my sister and said, oh my God, you will not believe what I just found out. And she was like, I'm not gonna go to sleep tonight. Like, why'd you tell me this? So Elisa Lam was caught on the hotel's security camera in the elevator, acting, as it says, erratically. She's basically, and you'll see in the footage, she steps into the elevator. She looks as if she's being followed by someone. She peers her head out the elevator door and then runs back in and hides. And it continues on and on for a while, and the elevator door is not shutting. It's really bizarre, her whole demeanor, and you can just tell, like, she looks like someone that's panicked, like someone that's being stalked. The ghost of the Night Stalker. Her body was then later on discovered in a water supply cistern, a water tank, on the hotel roof, following complaints from residents of odd tasting water and low pressure. The case remains unsolved. It's an unsolved mystery. They do not know how someone like her could have gotten into the water tank, because the water tank allegedly was untampered with. The only way she could have gone up there is, I don't know. No one knows how she could have gone up there. This is why it's unsolved. That was 2 years after we stayed at the hotel. And then there was another death afterwards of a 28-year-old man found dead outside the hotel. So let's call my sister, shall we? We want your firsthand experience about, or what's the word I'm looking for? We want your testimonial about your experience at the famous Hotel Cecil that I booked us back in 2011.
The decor I remember, just because I have those two pictures that I sent you, where it's all gray, so it looks just like you're in a jail cell. Like, it's all gray, it's all cement almost. Wait, what else I thought was weird is that this really cheap hotel or hostel was right next to the Marriott, so it was attached to the Marriott. Do you remember that?
Yeah, and I remember reading somewhere, allegedly, rumored, that, like, at some point it became, like, because of its, like, history, became, like, detached, or, like, they separated that from, like, the main hotel.
When we went there, I was just like, this is a weird hostel.
We were completely blindsided, like, completely deceived, and because of the rebranding, like, it literally says on there, they tried to rebrand it to stay on Main. And what's crazy is that they still have the old signage and the old, like, on the side of the hotel, not on the front, on the side, it still says Hotel Cecil. But yes. we never saw that. We didn't pay attention to that.
I remember we couldn't really find it because it's just this tiny little sliver of a building right next to the Marriott. So I remember the doggy statue when we checked in. That was weird. I did think we were in, like, a pet hotel accidentally, just because it was next to the Marriott, and I was like, well, this must be where people drop off their dogs. And then we got the room. I remember the bathroom being down the hallway, just like all the reviews say. I don't remember using the bathroom, but I think we went together because we were freaked out.
That's what I said too. I was like, I don't remember showering in that bathroom. I remember, like, us saying, like, we're just gonna get ready real quick and, like, go. Cause we, like, didn't wanna, like, stay there any longer than we had to. We basically took a quick nap.
Yeah, we, like, got there, we got ready for Lady Gaga. Cause there was some weird noises too. Like, the plumbing was, like, weird, so we could hear everything. We could hear, like, the rooms upstairs, like, next door. And then we were checking out really early, I think, too. One of us must have had to go to work the next day.
You did. I remember you did. Because I remember she was, she won't remember this, but I remember she was upset because trying to get back. So did you know that it's, like, in the middle of Skid Row?
Yeah.
So
I remember it was in the Fashion District, which is right next to Skid Row.
So when we were walking home and we were, like, bickering the whole way because that was the time of taxis.
Yeah.
And we couldn't get a taxi leaving the concert.
Yeah.
And we were bickering about, like, we couldn't find the hotel on the way home. Like, we couldn't find our way back. And, like, our phones were dying. I don't think we had, like, Google Maps or whatever. Like,
didn't have anything
at the time. So we were just, like, trying to find our way back. And, you know, walking, like, two girls post-concert looking super cute walking through, like, Skid Row at midnight. Like, that's just, like, a recipe for disaster. But we made it back to the hotel. But okay, so this is where, like, I have built my own conspiracy theory that I just think it's, like, so bizarre. The only reason we stayed at that hotel was because we were going to a Lady Gaga concert. The only reason I found out is because my friend Lauren and I went to a taping of A Star Is Born starring Lady Gaga, and then we came home to watch American Horror Story Hotel starring Lady Gaga, in which she told me, you know that this hotel is based off of a real hotel in LA, the Hotel Cecil. So
it's
three,
weird. The irony
of it.
Connecting all of these things and starring in the hotel, like, it's just weird.
Weird, yeah, Lady Gaga stars in the show about the hotel that we stayed in because we went to her concert. Freaking weird. I'm wearing my Lady Gaga Joanne t-shirt for this video. I kid you not, when I met Lady Gaga for the launch of House Labs, I had to fight it in me to be like, you can't tell her this 10-minute long story. Like, you can't give footnotes when you tell this story. You have to, like, tell the extended version. And I was like, Melissa, you don't want the first thing you say to Lady Gaga is like, oh my God, let me tell you about how I ended up at Hotel Cecil because of you. The crazy thing is, Hotel Cecil is reopening in 2021. Next year, this hotel is making a comeback. So it is currently and has been temporarily closed.
Did it close after they found that girl in the tank?
I think so. Like it's been closed since. I think it says in 2014 they sold it. A hotelier purchased it and is revamping it. It's gonna become residential and hotel. So
is this gonna be like $40 a night? It's like the cheapest option. That's why people stay there. It's really kind of hard to pass up that hotel.
And it was really truly like the nicest looking one for that price point based on the photos. That's why I'm so freaked out that like when I first started just looking up the hotel, I wasn't anticipating or expecting to see the new photos. I was looking through the photos and I'm like, ooh, look at these like old rooms. And then suddenly I see the room we stayed in a photo. Okay, I had to hang up with my sister real quick because we were going on a tangent. But yep, reopening 2021 with a rooftop pool, residential and hotel. Long-term stay, short stay, forever stay. That is going to conclude this story time. I know there was a lot of information in here, but just know what I think is so bizarre is the fact that Lady Gaga is literally at the center of this entire story. All for the love of Gaga. Just kidding. Like, it's just so weird. So weird. Comment down below your thoughts. What do you think? Have you experienced something similar? Share your stories down below. I am still really shaken by it. My sister as well. She's like, I just, the whole like Lady Gaga part of the story is what trips me up. And just the fact that we even stayed there when someone like Mykie won't even stay there, Glam and Gore. It's just crazy. Will I revisit in 2021 when it reopens? I'm guessing no. I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, happy Halloween. Stay, healthy and safe, whatever it is that you're doing. And I hope that this video gave you a little bit of a spooky vibe. Didn't spook you too badly. Sleep well tonight. I love you guys. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video, hit the notification bell, give it a like if you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.